Christmas by Injunction by O. Henry. Cherokee was the civic father of Yellowhammer. Yellowhammer was a new mining town, constructed mainly of canvas and undressed pine. Cherokee was a prospector. One day, while his burro was eating quartz and pine burrs, Cherokee turned up with his pick a nugget, weighing 30 ounces. He staked his claim, and then, being a man of breadth and hospitality, sent out invitations to his friends in 3 states to drop in and share his luck. Not one of the invited guests sent regrets. They rolled in from the Gila country, from Salt River, from the Pecos, from Albuquerque and Phoenix and Santa Fe, and from the camps intervening. When 1,000 citizens had arrived and taken up claims, they named the town Yellowhammer, appointed a vigilance committee, and presented Cherokee with a watch chain made of nuggets. 3 hours after the presentation ceremonies, Cherokee's claim played out. He had located a pocket instead of a vein. He abandoned it and staked others one by one. Luck had kissed her hand to him. Never afterward did he turn up enough dust in Yellowhammer to pay his bar bill. But his 1,000 invited guests were mostly prospering, and Cherokee smiled and congratulated them. Yellowhammer was made up of men who took off their hats to a smiling loser, so they invited Cherokee to say what he wanted.
"Me?" said Cherokee. "Oh, grubstakes will be about the thing. I reckon I'll prospect up along in the Mariposas. If I strike it up there, I will most certainly let you all know about the facts. I never was any hand to hold out cards on my friends."
In May, Cherokee packed his burro and turned its thoughtful, mouse-colored forehead to the north. Many citizens escorted him to the undefined limits of Yellowhammer and bestowed upon him shouts of commendation and farewells. 5 pocket flasks without an air bubble between contents and cork were forced upon him, and he was bidden to consider Yellowhammer in perpetual commission for his bed, bacon and eggs, and hot water for shaving, in the event that luck did not see fit to warm her hands by his campfire in the Mariposas. The name of the father of Yellowhammer was given him by the gold hunters, in accordance with their popular system of nomenclature. It was not necessary for a citizen to exhibit his baptismal certificate in order to acquire a cognomen. A man's name was his personal property. For convenience in calling him up to the bar, and in designating him among other blue-shirted bipeds, a temporary appellation, title, or epithet was conferred upon him by the public. Personal peculiarities formed the source of the majority of such informal baptisms. Many were easily dubbed geographically, from the regions from which they confessed to have hailed. Some announced themselves to be Thompsons and Adamses and the like, with the brazenness and loudness that cast a cloud upon their titles. A few vaingloriously and shamelessly uncovered their proper and indisputable names. This was held to be unduly arrogant, and did not win popularity. One man who said he was Chesterton L.C. Belmont, and proved it by letters, was given till sundown to leave the town. Such names as Shorty, Bowlegs, Texas, Lazy Bill, Thirsty Rogers, Limping Riley, The Judge, and California Ed were in favor. Cherokee derived his title from the fact that he claimed to have lived for a time with that tribe in the Indian nation. On the 20th day of December, Baldy, the mail rider, brought Yellowhammer a piece of news.
"What do I see in Albuquerque?" said Baldy to the patrons of the bar. "But Cherokee, all embellished and festooned up like the Tsar of Turkey, and lavishing money in bulk. Him and me seen the elephant and the owl, and we had specimens of this Seidlitz powder wine, and Cherokee, he audits all the bills COD. His pockets look like a pool table's after a 15-ball run."
"Cherokee must have struck pay ore," remarked California Ed.
"Well, he's white. I'm much obliged to him for success."
"Seems like Cherokee would ramble down to Yellowhammer and see his friends," said another, slightly aggrieved. "But that's the way. Prosperity is the finest cure there is for lost forgetfulness."
"You wait," said Baldy. "I'm coming."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.